Children, I think you all learned your exams well. Now we have to discuss the next chapter, speed, distance and time. We have already studied this speed and distance in your physics textbook. So what is speed? Speed is a body in the distance covered by the body in unit time. Okay, here we have a formula, speed equals distance by time. That means body covers a distance in a fixed time, that is known as speed. So from this formula we can find the formula of distance. Distance equals speed into time, so when we cross multiply this, and time equals, if you want to calculate time, distance by speed. These three formula you have to by heart, then you can do all the questions in this section. And here we have to remember the units always. Okay, distance, if the distance is in meter and time is in second, and the speed will be always in meter per second. Meter per second, it will be written like this, meter per second, or ms raised to minus 1. This is better, meter per second. If distance is in kilometer and time is in hour, then the speed is kilometer per hour, that is kilometer per hour. This unit is we have to write in this chapter. That speed, the unit is very important. Okay, in order to find the distance, speed is in meter per second, and time will be in seconds. And in speed is in kilometer per hour, and time is in hour. Just like that, time also you have to remember the units. Okay, now we will move on to some questions. First we discuss some exercise question. That's a train covers 51 km in 3 hours. Calculate in speed. Okay, you can easily write speed equals, what is the formula? Distance by time. Distance is, in this question, distance is given as, distance equals 51 km and time equals 3 hours. Okay, so you can write 51 by 3. Directly we can divide in 5, 3, 1 times 21, 7. So 17, distance is in kilometer and time is in hour. So unit will be kilometer per hour. That is per means kilometer by hour. That is kilometer by hour. This is we are writing like this, kilometer per hour. And there is a second part also in this question. How far does the train go in 30 minutes? So always remember thing, you have to give concentration about the units is given. Again, the calculation is very simple, but the units will be, we have to think important, very important. That is, here the time is given as 30 minutes, but speed we have calculated here, kilometer per hour, 17 kilometer per hour, that is in hour we have calculated. That is one hour the train will travel 17 kilometer, but we have to find out the when the train will come in 30 minutes. So first we have to convert this 30 minutes into hour. How will you convert in 1 hour equals 60 minutes, isn't it? So convert 30 minutes into hour, get divided by 60. It makes smaller, we can cut it zeros, 3 and 6, we can divide by 3, 1 by 2 hour. So now you can calculate how far does, that is you have to calculate distance equals speed into time. Speed is 17 into 1 by 2. 17 by 2. If you want, you can make it mixed fraction or divide as a decimal. 17 divided by 2, 8 times, isn't it? 16 remainder 1. This will give decimal 10. For it is 8.5 kilometer. Just like you can calculate the values. Okay. So give more importance to what is the units given in time and kilometer distance. Okay, otherwise when we calculate the speed you will make mistake. The motorist travels the distance between two towns, which is 65 kilometer in 2 hours 10 minutes. Find the speed in meter per second. So you always give importance to the question, what we have to find out. Okay, here it is asked them to find out speed in meter per minute, but in the question distance is given kilometer and time is in given hour and minute. So first we have to convert this kilometer into meter and time into minutes, then only we get the speed in meter per second. Okay, thus distance equals 65 kilometer. We know that 1 kilometer equals 1000 meter. So 65 kilometer will become 65 into 1000 becomes 65000 meter. Now time, that is 2 hour 10 minutes. So we have to convert this 2 hour into minutes. Then we know 1 hour equals 60 minutes. So 2 into 60. 2 into 60 plus the 10 minutes more. So you have to add this 10 minutes also. 2 into 60, 120 plus 10, it will be 130 minutes. Now we can calculate speed. Speed equals distance by time. This distance we have calculated as 65,000 meter divided by time equals 130 minutes. So each zeros we can be calculate 13 into 5, 65, isn't it? So 500, we have 500 meter per minute is the answer. So we have to remember about the unit always. One next question. This question is, a train travels 700 meters in 35 seconds. Find what is the speed in kilometer per hour. So we have to calculate speed in kilometer per hour, but the distance is given in meter and time is given in second. So first we have to convert the distance and time into distance in kilometer and time into hour. How will you convert? Okay, so distance is given as 700 meter. So we know that 1000 meter equals 1 kilometer. So to convert meter into kilometer, we have to divide it by 1000. Now it become kilometer. There is no need to divide it now. We can do in the calculation the final steps. Okay, then time equals 35 seconds. So seconds we have to calculate into hour. You know that 1 hour equals 60 minutes and 1 minute equals 60 seconds. So we have to convert this hour into seconds. So what we have to do, first convert into minute, then only into seconds. That is 35 divided by, when we divide by 60, it be converted into this second. When this second is, when we divide by 60, it become into minute. Now again we have to divide one more 60, then only it become hour. Okay, now we can find the speed equals distance by time. That is 700 by 1000, this is a distance, this become kilometer. Time equals 35 by 60 into 60 hour. That means a fraction divided by another fraction means multiply by reciprocal. This into 60 into 60 by 35. Now we can easily calculate. Otherwise when we divide here and here, it be, we will get a decimal numbers, then it will become difficult to calculate over here. Okay, so now we can divide these two zeros by dividing by 100. One more zero here. Then we can divide this 735 by 7 is 1 times, it become 5. Then now 6 into 60 by 5, we can divide 60 by 5 is 1 times 1, 12. 12 into 5 is 60. Now we have 6 into 12, answer is 6 into 12. What is this? 12, 72 kilometer per hour. So we got the answer. Just like we have to move to another question, fourth one. The racing car covers 600 km in 3 hours 20 minutes. Find its speed in meter per second. Look at here, meter per second, but the distance is given in kilometer and the time is in hour and minutes, just like the last question. So first we have to find the speed in meter per seconds. Then find how much distance will the car cover in 50 minutes, that we have to calculate. So I have done this question for you, I can go through it. Distance equals 600 kilometer. So we need the answer in meter per second. So I convert this kilometer into meter, that is 600 into 1000. So it become 6 lakh meter, isn't it? Okay. 6 zeros is 3 plus 2, that is 5. 3 plus 2, 5. Then time, 3 hour 20 minutes. This hour we have to convert in the second. This 3 into 60 into 6. When we multiply 60, it becomes minutes. Again, one more 60, then only it becomes seconds plus 20 minutes. This 20 minutes also we have to convert into seconds. That is 20 into 60. So I multiply it and I add it. I got it 12,000 seconds. If you convert all this here, then very easy for calculation over here. Otherwise, it will make a mistake. Speed equals distance by time, total distance in meter by total time in seconds. So you can easily calculate 600 by 12. So we got 250 meter per seconds. Okay, that speed we got in meter per second. Then second part we have how much distance is covered in 50 seconds. So already we have calculated speed over here. So and the time is given 50 seconds. Then distance equals speed into time, 50 into 50, 2500 meter. The answer will get in meter. If you want to make it in kilometer, 1 kilometer equals 1000 meter. So when we divide by 1000, 2.5 kilometer it will become. Okay, I will explain one more question. Remaining question you have to try yourself. Rohit goes 350 km in 5 hours, find his speed. The direct kilometer and time is given in kilometer, distance is given in kilometer, time is in hour. So we can directly calculate speed. 350 by 5 will get speed. What is 70 km per hour? The distance covered by Rohit is 6.2 km. So distance we have to calculate. Already we got the speed, that is 350 by 5, that is 70 km per hour. So what we have to do over here, 70 into speed into time, 6.2. When we multiply, we will get the answer, the distance. Now, third part, the time taken by him to cover 210 km. Here we have to calculate time. So distance is given, formula for time equal distance by speed. Distance is 210 divided by speed. Already we have calculated over here, 70. So we will get 3 hour. So easily, if you by heart the formula, you can easily do all the questions over here. Okay, there are the remaining 2-3 questions are there. Some are done for you. There is one more different question. I will explain it. Look at this question, 8th one. A man walked the distance 5 km in 2 hours, then he goes in a bus by to the nearby town with 40 km in further 2 hours. From there, he goes to his office in an auto rickshaw at a distance of 5 km in half an hour. So, what is the average speed during the whole journey? Here we have to calculate average speed. Do you know what is the formula for average speed? It is speed equal distance by time itself, but here given different distance and different time. So to find the average speed, you have to calculate total distance and total time. Then we can divide distance by time. I'll show it. Total distance equal, first we have to add 5 km plus 40 km plus 5, so total is 50 km total distance. Just like total time also you have to calculate 2 hour plus half an hour. So when we all 2 plus 2 4 and half hour. For the further calculation we have to make it mixed fraction into improper, that is 2 4 into 8 plus 1 9 by 2 hour. Okay, then average speed equals total distance by total time, that is 50 km by 9 by 2 hour. When we take this fraction, we take the reciprocal, 50 into 2 by 9, that is 100 by 9. Make it mixed fraction, 11 1 by 9 kilometer per hour. Just like we can calculate average speed. There is one more average speed question, 9th one. Jagan went to another town such that he covers 240 kilometer by car going 60 kilometer per hour, and then he covers 80 kilometer by train going in 100 km per hour, and the rest is 200 km he covers in by bus going 50 km per hour. What is the average speed? Here is also you have to find out the average speed, but one step is different. The previous question, it is given directly given the distance and time, so very, it is very easy to calculate. But here distance is given, but time is not given. Instead of that, speed is given. So almost all the students doing find the average speed, they all add all the these speeds and take its average. It is very wrong. From this speed, you have to calculate the time taken by that each journey. Then we have to add the take the total time and total distance, then find the average speed. Okay, I will show it. So first distance 240, speed is 60 km per hour. From using these two, you can take the time, find the time. First journey 240 by 60, 4 km, just like the remaining two, 80 km and 100 km per hour. Then time equals 4 by 5 hour. If you want, you can make it mixed, decimal. It is, I take it as fractions for the easiness for to calculate the remaining steps. Then third one, 200 km, they take 50 km per hour. So time equals, there is also 4 hour. Now you can take total distance. So total distance we got 520 km when we add this all distance. Then time also taken 4 plus 4 plus 4 by 5. So 8 5 by 4, 44 by 5 hours. Then average speed equal total distance by total time. It become 59 1 by 11 km. You can calculate over here. Just like you can find the average speed. There is one or two example questions are there for the average speed. So do all the exercise. Remaining question, I have given one question for your homework. The remaining are in your notebook. Okay. Thank you. We wind up today's class. Thank you.